りですか。 name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good evening.
Good evening, Father.
As we present ourselves before God, we come with thanks and gratitude for his love. Today is the first Sunday in ordinary time of your seed. Today we are being challenged, yet an obligation for Christians to speak the truth, even in the circumstances where we give our life. Jesus suffered the same fate for the rest of our other brothers, yet they stood their ground. And so, my dear friends, let us tell the truth, especially in the second reading where Paul gave us stanzas of love, what love is all about. Love endures, love forgives, love is hopeful. Let us include our own private intentions, remembering the intention for the Mass today, and those that ask us to pray for them. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery worthily, let us call to mind our sins and ask God forgiveness and pardon. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, my thoughts, my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do. Therefore, I ask Christ as a virgin, all the angels and saints, you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me, Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to the last in life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. But do you gird your loins? Stand up and tell them, all that I command you, but not crushed on their account, as though I would leave you crushed before them. For it is I this day who have made you a fortified city, a pillar of iron, a wall of brass, against the whole land, against Judah's kings and princes, against its priests and people. They will fight against you, but not prevail over you. For I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord." The word of the Lord. Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, if I hand my body over so that I may be burned, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It's not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, it will be brought to nothing. For we know partially and we prophesy partially. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk as a child, think as a child, reason as a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. At present, we see indistinctly as in a mirror, but then in face to face. At present, I know partially. Then I shall know fully as I am fully known. So faith, hope, love remain. These three, but the greatest of this is love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
Yes.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus began speaking in the synagogue, saying, "Today, the scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." And all spoke highly of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They also asked, "Is not this the son of Joseph?" He said to them, "Surely you will quote me this proverb, 'Physician, cure yourself,' and say, 'Do here in your native place the things that we heard were done in Capernaum, And he said, Amen, I say to you, no prophet is accepted in his own native place. Indeed, I tell you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the sky was closed for 3.5 years, and a severe famine spread over the entire land. It was to none of these that Elijah was sent, nor only to a widow in Zarephath, the land of Sidon. Again, there were many lepers in Israel during the time of Elisha, the prophet, yet not one of them was cleansed, but only Naaman, the Syrian. When the people in the synagogue heard this, they were all filled with fury. They rose up, drove him out of the town, and led him to be thrown on the hill on which their town had been built, to haul him down headlong. But Jesus passed through the midst of them and went away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, today's reading reminds you and I that we are called to be prophets. By virtue of our baptism, as a prophet, as a priest, and as a king. Because prophet is one who is called to speak the truth in love. Since the prophet is said to speak the truth, his message risks opposition and rejection. The first reading is about the call of Jeremiah, who is chosen by God even before he was born. God said, I have appointed you as a prophet to the nation. Stand up and tell them all I command you. This particular passage is always being spoken at ordination. If we go down through the story, you will also understand where God warned us as priests. If you do not speak the truth, I will punish you. And God said, stand up and tell them all I command you. Jeremiah also warned that his mission would not be easy because his message will certainly meet opposition. The reason why Jeremiah accepts such an unpopular mission is God. It's God's love and faithfulness in the midst of persecution. It's not always easy to go to war because we know the consequences of the war. But are you going to avoid going to war lest you die? When you know that going to war will save the greater good, defend the country, and defend the defenseless. He said, they will fight against you, but they shall not overcome you. For I am with you to deliver you. So if you have this assurance, why shy away from responsibility? Bringing up children is not easy, because you know what it does. Carrying 9 months pregnancy is not easy. When you deliver the child, are you going to abandon him or her in the hospital? You take him home. Nurture him or her. That length of years, sleepless night, but all in joy and love. My dear friends, this is a clear reminder that it is not the eloquence of God's messenger that counts, but their clear witness to God's love. Against this background, we see the meaning of Paul's message in the second reading. Without the kind of love that Paul speaks about, Jeremiah or any messengers of God will fail. Love that is patient and kind and never jealous, a love that is always ready to forgive, to trust, hope, and endure, whatever comes is a powerful driving force. You'll be hated when you stand up for justice and truth. Your child might call you names or nag or refuse to do what you tell him or her to do. But will you stop telling her the right thing? Because she will be angry at you, upset. No. We must continue to do the job assigned to us, to nurture and bring us to love God and humanity. That love sustained Paul in his own ministry till martyrdom in Rome, and the same love inspired Jesus in his ministry. Even though he was rejected by his own people, as we heard in the Gospel, yet Jesus endures all insults, persecution to his own death and resurrection. Jesus died out of love. Today's Gospel passage is a clear reminder that when God's messengers speak the truth in love, they risk rejection, opposition, hatred, because people criticize everything you say. People don't like us. They don't like one who says the truth, not just the priest, but indeed you and I. If you have a friend who does something wrong and you tell the friend, this is not the right thing, he will hate you. He'll call you names. The least, he or she will start avoiding you. But you'll stand in a greater position to tell him or her, if anything happened or happens, you say, did I not tell you that? That's a good friend. Not the one who will say, I would have told you that. In fact, I've been planning to tell you not to do this thing you're doing. In the Gospel, Jesus faces such a rejection, not because he's a local young man of Nazareth, but because his biblical message about God's universal love and salvation contains a truth that the audience cannot deny, and that angers the religious and political leaders of his time. Consequently, he is immediately considered dangerous and subversive. Out of anger, they sprung to their feet and hustled him out of the town, intending to throw him down the cliff, and he slipped through the crowd and walked away. How did it happen? Perhaps they were seeing Jesus as ordinary human being like them, just as God promised Jeremiah, I'll be with you. Liberators are always victims of persecution from holy status quo, perpetrated by social, political, and religious leaders. They don't like to be told that what they're doing is wrong. If you do, in most countries around the world, they will kill you. Lucky we have here that everybody has the freedom of speech. Say it as it is, because of your fundamental human right. Today, with Jesus and Jeremiah, we are called to announce the welcome truth to all peoples, because with true love on our side, we will pass through these persecutions without being overcome, for God is with us to rescue us. My dear friends, as we go on today, the readings remind us that our call to discipleship, like that of Jeremiah and Jesus, must be rooted in love, even in an unfamiliar territory. The readings also assures us that God never abandons his faithful messengers when they speak the truth in love. Jesus said that no matter the evil we see around us, no matter how discouraging a situation may seem, we must place our trust and our hope in God. We must remain assured that he will not abandon us. Finally, just like Jeremiah, Jesus, and Paul, we too are challenged to live our calling as Christians, even if in doing so, we may risk our comfort, rejection, even our lives. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
things remain. For us men of our salvation, who came down from heaven. Almighty Holy Spirit, was incarnate of Virgin Mary, amen. Our saint was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered dead and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with scriptures. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of our Father, who will come again in order to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceed from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. At baptism, we have come to share the prophetic mission of Jesus. This call has become clearer at our confirmation. Aware of the difficulty of being faithful prophets in our society, we pray.
Please respond, Lord, grant us courage, that the whole church, under the guidance of her leaders, may fulfill her mission of proclaiming the word of God to all peoples. Let us pray.
Lord, grant us courage.
That all believers may faithfully fulfill their task of being prophets of God in the places where they live. Let us pray.
Lord, grant us courage.
That those who are persecuted on account of their commitment to promote justice may bravely persevere in their mission. Let us pray.
Lord, grant us courage.
That those who are promoting dialogue and peace between warring factions may succeed in their praiseworthy efforts. Let us pray.
Lord, grant us courage.
That those who find it hard to love as Christ did may persevere in their effort, remembering that love is all that matters most in our aspiration to attain eternal life. Let us pray.
Lord, grant us courage.
That all Catholics may ever more firmly believe in the presence of Jesus in the Eucharist, the sacrament of love. Let us pray.
Lord, grant us courage.
That the observance of Pro-Life Sunday may reawaken in all Catholics a greater appreciation of the preciousness of human life and of their duty to promote and defend in all aspects. Let us pray.
Lord, grant us courage.
For those who have died, especially
with Sissy,
special way. May they live forever with Christ in the glory of the resurrection. Let us pray.
Lord, grant us courage.
Let us pray in silence for our own personal intentions. Let us pray.
Lord, grant us courage.
Lord, grant us courage and wisdom, faithfulness, and constancy in living out a prophetic mission in spite of mockery and persecution. You will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. We present our gifts at the altar in thanksgiving for God's love. And so we sing, O God, you search.
and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, we bring to you all the needs and offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them with prayer and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. By rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, is without end, we are glad. He took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in hope of resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, Lord, we pray. And the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, bless Joseph, our spouse, bless the apostles and all the saints, please you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs with eternal life, we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Deliver us, God, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. We are waiting with blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory of Jesus.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. The body of God of Christ, keep us safe to our life.
For those at home who are unable to receive the body and blood of Christ, we offer this prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. And so we go to the altar to receive the body and blood, soul and divinity of our sweet Jesus, and we say, Lord, who at thy first glories. Thank you.
Let us pray. Nourished by these the redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, through faith made by grace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before the final blessings, few announcements here. One, the blessing of the truth will be held on the February 10th at 8 a.m. Mass. The monthly coffee and conversation is cancelled until further notice. Due to the surge of coronavirus, for the protection of yourself and others, we encourage everyone to wear a mask while attending Mass. Thank you for your understanding. The Lord be with you. Bow down and receive God's blessing. May the Lord make you kind and compassionate that you may become instrument of his love. Amen. May he give you a deeper appreciation for his gift of life. Amen. May he make you strong in the moments of trial and wise in your judgment. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Have a peaceful night. Thank you.
Before we leave this holy place, let us say, Lord, you give the great commission.
Thank you.
job.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, what's your name?
Santiago.
Santiago?